So remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know.
Please remain seated as our graduates process into the church. And this Mass is being offered for the Memorial Mass intentions for Daniel Weiser, Mary Louise McDonald, Dr. Francis Gilroy, and Joseph Dovin.
Thank you. Please rise for our opening hymn. Here at this table, the lyrics are also inside your program. Verses 1, 3, and 5.
And for all their efforts of educating them throughout the years. We also welcome all fathers on this Father's Day. Now to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins as we speak the Lord's mercy and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God our Father, you send your Son among us to unite us all by serving all. We pray today that our graduates may build up the body of Christ, your Son, by rendering humble service to the community. May they grow to be responsible persons, always willing to do what is good, and never afraid to stand for what is true. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Our Old Testament reading will be read by Nicholas Pisano.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branch, tear off a tender shoot, and plant high on a mountain, and high on a lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit, and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of boughs, and all trees in the fields shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
They shall bear fruit even in old age. Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please Him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense, according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land, and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow, he knows not how. Of its own accord the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he builds a sickle at once, for the harvest has come. He said, to what shall we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed that, when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants, and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade. With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord. It is, first of all, a time of looking back, a time when congratulations are in order for past accomplishments. It is also a time for looking forward, setting your sights on new goals and new challenges. I think both of these thoughts are appropriate to this occasion. There are times in life when we need to kind of look backward. We need to kind of take stock of where we have been and be grateful for what has been. Graduation Day is one of those times. So to you, young friends, I offer you my congratulations. You've marked a significant milestone in your life. You take with you many fond memories of your time at your particular high school. You have accomplished much thus far in your lives, and now your energies will be to build on what you have learned and contribute to whatever you plan to do, whether it's going to college or finding employment. And so now we look at the other direction, challenges of the future. While your immediate future is one of continuing your education or joining the workforce, nevertheless, it is important that you have a clear idea of how you will approach this new experience. Hopefully, there will be that determination to build on the great education that you have received thus far. You have been given a strong foundation by your families, your teachers, administrators, coaches, and other staff persons. And please always remember those who have been a positive influence on your lives. Since we're also celebrating Father's Day this weekend, this story applies not only to fathers, but to all of you, reminding us once again of how important it is to set our priorities to such a degree that they guide us in whatever we do in our lives. We know pro golfer Bubba Watson, he listed his priorities in his Twitter description as Christian, husband, daddy, pro golfer. He and his wife Angie have two adopted children, and Watson says that the joy of being the father far outweighs any professional success he has achieved. He took some time off from golf after the first adoption so he could bond with his son. As he said, "I had to be there for my son, so golf was the farthest thing from my mind. Trying to be a good husband, a good dad, was the most important thing." Good fathers and mothers have a natural impulse to protect their children and to serve as an example in tough times. I heard another speaker talk about how he learned a lesson about being a parent when he finally realized, after ignoring his son's request to spend some time with him practicing baseball, because his work again always took his priority, he finally realized that he needed to spend time with his son, and this made all the difference in his son's life. He went on to talk about the things that he learned from that experience and that are so important in the life of young people. For parents who realize that they are the first educators of their children in the faith, and that a religious education program or a Catholic school supports what the parents are teaching their children. He then talked about perseverance, about not being discouraged when things do not go as planned. And finally, about passion, being passionate about what you are doing and again trying to do your best. It was all about having a faith perspective in whatever we are doing in life and realizing that the most important thing in life is not about how much wealth you're going to accumulate, but being the best person you can be and sharing that with family. And that this is where real joy comes from. Again, the joy that Pope Francis often talks about as being essential for Christian living in our world today. At one of our celebrations for youth, the priest emphasized that there's so much pressure on young people today, and so many influences, and we're aware of them, that will question what you value as important. But to counteract these influences, he said, you needed to stay close to your families. Stay close to your faith. Be with those who are going to help you become the best person that you can become. For we are here today to appreciate what has been good from the past, and again, how to appreciate the future and approach the future. Over the next few weeks, you'll be hearing many talks school classmates, your principal, and others, and you will get some sound advice as you venture forward. But ultimately, you know, it is about who you are.
One of the best things I can tell you is that you are a child of God. You know, the world tells us many things about who we are, a loser, unlovable, unworthy, incapable. And that can be pretty discouraging until we are reminded that we are children of God. We are loved with an everlasting love that gives us worth and confidence and a sense of purpose in life. So as we leave here today, I hope that you do so with a new determination and confidence because of the one who adopted us as his own children. And my hope and prayer for you is that you will stay connected in some way to your faith in whatever direction your life takes. You know, it won't be very easy all the time, but the choice, again, is yours, as you will be on your own and nobody telling you what to do. So that's going to be a new experience, right? Hold on to what you value, what you have learned from your family, from your school, from your church, and continue to grow. Do not be afraid, and remember that whatever you face, that God is there. As we will sing in the closing song, I send you out on a mission of love, and know that I am with you until the end of the world. Congratulations, and the best of all good things. We'll now continue with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray to the Father of light that he may truly become the salt and light of the world.
For the Pope, bishops, and priests of the Catholic Church, that God our Father will guide these men to be wise fathers for the faithful, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our high school graduates, who we honor at this baccalaureate mass, that our Heavenly Father will bless the next stage of their journey, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the graduates may know the Spirit's loving guidance and strength throughout their days, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all fathers, that they may be given the graces needed to be a source of love, wisdom, strength, and faith for their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our fathers, grandfathers, and those who are called to fatherhood in all its forms, that the love and appreciation shown to them today may continue throughout the year, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For fathers who have lost a child through death, that their faith may give them hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick, may God's healing presence bring them comfort. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, and for Camilla Kunkel, who died this past week, and for all the deceased fathers, may they rejoice in the loving presence of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intentions that we hold in our hearts, and for the memorial donor mass intentions for Daniel Weiser, Mary Louise McDonald, Dr. Francis Gilroy, and Joseph G. Dovin, for whom we offer this mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, hear our petitions. Let the light of Christ shine in us through our words and actions. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
I pray that God would fill your heart with dreams.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God our Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks for the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race and who always walk with us in the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when as once with the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer and the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, with all their bishops, with priests and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Grant also to us when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Oh,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 623, Tend the Ground, number 623.
Bless us.
Throughout this annual baccalaureate mass, we again offer our congratulations to our high school graduates from our parishes. As was mentioned in the introduction, is a time to looking back at all that you have accomplished over these years, and for looking forward, all that you hope to accomplish in the future. So today is a cause for celebration, not only for acknowledging what you have achieved, but also to recognize those who have been instrumental in bringing you to this moment in time. So at this time, I'd like to acknowledge all of our those graduates who are present here, and as I announce your name, please come forward to receive a small gift from the parish. Please remain in the sanctuary until all have been called. And a number of them could not make it for the Mass today, but I will call their names and acknowledge them. Kiernan Cipolla, Bridget Cronin, small gift from the parish, okay. Isaac Garcia, Sebastian Konui, Gianna Palmer, Melissa Pisano, Nicholas Pisano, I'll give you her sisters. Ava Scoville. Evan Sternquist. Gavin Walsh. Ethan Wojcik. Aiden Yeko. Are there any other graduates here by any chance that I missed? Okay. Also, on behalf of Gloria Sullivan, who was unable to be here today, she would usually present the Joseph Sullivan Award to two people, and I would like to just announce that their names. The Joseph Sullivan Award this year will go to Bridget Cronin and Evan Sternquist. Okay. So again, so at this time, I'd just like to offer a special blessing for our graduates. Gracious God, we ask your blessing on these young men and women who stand before you today. May the ending of their high school days also be for them a beginning of new experiences, new learnings, and new understanding of themselves. And help us as parish communities to continue to support our youth and to stay connected to these young people. Be with them on their journeys and remain always in their hearts. This we ask you in the name of your Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Once again, congratulations to all of you. Let us pray. Lord, in the spiritual food you have given back to us, the sacrifice we offered you in thanksgiving, the saving sacrament of Christ your Son, by these gifts of strength and joy, sustain in your service and bring us to your gift of eternal life, and grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Again, thank you all for being here. Again, we congratulate our graduates, and there are refreshments in the vestibule of the church following the Mass today, so you can join us back there. And on this Father's Day, we will have a special blessing again for all fathers. God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth, and grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And again, a happy Father's Day to all of our fathers. Have a great week, everyone. Stay cool this week, right?
For sure.
The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is on the back page of your program. It's I Send You Out. The refrain is there, but if you know the verses, please join and sing along.